What's good, YouTubers and YouTubettes? This is JB Sports, back again with another one. We're going to discuss a fight that got announced yesterday. To the surprise of many, including myself, WBC interim heavyweight champion, Dillian White. You know, he kind of stole this mantra from Adrian the Problem Broner. He called himself the Can Man. Anybody can get it. Basically, just stole Adrian Broner's mantra. Man, nobody even talked about that, man. But I'm going to bring that up, man. Just a small caveat, man, I'm going to bring out for you guys, man. That was, you know, I remember when he first came out with that. I think he beat Lucas Brown. He started talking about anybody can get it. I'm like, God damn. What is this going to take? Adrian the Problem Broner's. Gonna take his mantra, man. Gonna take his words and put them on to himself. That kind of remind me of when Dwight Howard was calling himself Superman, knowing before him Shaq was calling himself Superman. But that's neither here nor there. Let's talk about the real reason. The real reason why Dillian White is fighting Otto Valim. You know, when this news broke yesterday, people was like, "Oh man. God damn, that Dillian White's something else, man. This dude here would be willing to fight anybody. This guy could just sit back, kick back, relax, and wait on his title opportunity against the winner of Tyson Fury versus Deontay Wilder. He is the interim WBC heavyweight champion. That don't mean you're going to get the title shot next. I want to let you guys know that right off the rip. But, you know, people were convincing themselves that was the case. He would get the winner. He could just sit back and wait, maybe fight a, you know, a quote-unquote tune-up. You heard names like Jermaine Franklin was going to be the likely opponent. You know, Prince Charles Morning kind of threw his name in the hat. He basically called out Dillian White, but Dillian White wasn't trying to fight him. But I'm going to tell you the real reason why this fight has come to fruition. And the real reason why is, look no further than Sky Sports. You got to understand that Dillian White is a pay-per-view star in the UK. He is the number two pay-per-view attraction in the UK behind Anthony Joshua. He is basically the number two guy behind Anthony Joshua on the Matchroom's boxing. And when you are on that level, you can't put him in the ring with anybody. Jermaine Franklin, you can't put that fight on Sky pay-per-view. That fight's not going to sell like Dillian White against Alexander Povetkin, Dillian White against Joseph Parker, Dillian White against Derek Chisora. Not gonna sell. But that being the case, that's the reason why Otto Valim was pulled. That was one of the reasons why, excuse me, Otto Valim was selected as opponent for Dillian White. Now they probably really wanted Andy Ruiz, but Andy Ruiz is unavailable, and I don't think Andy Ruiz was gonna take the fight even if he was available. You know, Andy Ruiz is dealing with an injury that pretty much is gonna sideline him for the rest of 2021. You will probably see him come back in 2022. There's been rumors going around that his next fight will be against Luis King Kong Ortiz. They will possibly put that fight on a Fox pay-per-view. So he's out of the equation. Now you look at the Prince Charles Martin, who is known to the UK boxing fan, as he was the first victim of AJ's first title claim, as he was able to take the IBF heavyweight title away from Prince Charles Martin in devastating fashion, stopped him in the second round, I believe. It looked like Prince Charles Martin was afraid of the moment, man. Like he was a deer in headlights in that fight. I think he's a better fighter since then. He's a dangerous opponent. He got 25 knockouts in 29. My bad. He got 25 knockouts in 30 fights. So he's a much more dangerous opponent. So even though he's known over there in the UK, you can sell that fight over there in the UK, unlike a Jermaine Franklin fight. He's a little bit too dangerous for Dillian White and his suspect chin. So that leads us to Otto Valim. Otto Valim is a good boxer, probably one of the best boxers in the heavyweight division. I probably put him right under Tyson Fury as far as just pure boxers in the heavyweight division. I probably put him right up under Tyson Fury, and probably right side by side with Anthony Joshua as probably the best boxers in the heavyweight division. but he don't have no power. Now, when you look at his record, he's got 14 knockouts in 23 fights. So a lot of people say, wait a minute, JB Sports, he's got 14 knockouts in 23 fights. He has power, but you got to look at who he's fought. You got to check the resume. When he stepped up in competition against Tyson Fury, he did knock down or knock out Tyson Fury. Now, he hurt him real bad in that 12th round, but that was due to the fact he had a bad cut over his eye, and he hit him right on that cut. So I think that affected him more than anything. Now, he did not hurt at all Dominique Brazil. Now, he won that fight very comfortably. He won that fight in a wide margin. I think he won that fight 9-3. So he basically washed Dominique Brazil. But he did not knock out, knock down, hurt, or wobble Dominique Brazil throughout the 12-round fight. So he don't have power, especially when he steps up in competition. Now, he might have knocked down a couple of journeymen over there in his home country, a bunch of dishwashers and doormen over there, and a bunch of bus drivers and stuff like that over there in his home country. He probably knocked them guys out, but that's not saying much. When he stepped up to the level, as far as a level in the heavyweight division, like, you know, top 15, top 20 level in the heavyweight division, when you talk about Tyson Fury, who's probably number one, you talk about Dominique Brazil, who's probably, you know, who basically is a top 15, top 20 heavyweight, he did not display that type of power. So I think he's a guy that fits the bill as far as name-wise, a guy that you can sell over there on Sky Pay-Per-View, but a guy that's not as dangerous as a Prince Charles Martin. That's the reason why he was selected as the opponent for Dillian White. So we will see what happens. We will see what transpires. But just wanted to drop this little video, man. You know, like I said, Dillian White was getting a lot of standing ovations, a round of applause, so to speak, for him fighting Alto Valim, man. A lot of people was getting them credit, saying, oh, man, Dillian White probably got one of the best resumes in the heavyweight division outside of Anthony Joshua. And I told you guys time and time again that the heavyweight division is three deep. You got Tyson Fury, you got Deontay Wilder, you got Anthony Joshua. Everybody else are solid fighters, but nothing to write home about. And that's the case with Dillian White, man. He's not been in there. He's fought AJ. Give him credit, though. He has been in the ring with AJ, but that was a green AJ. That was before AJ was a world champion. And he had AJ in serious trouble in that fight. If he was able to get AJ up out of there, he probably could have been in the position that AJ is in right now. But that wasn't the case. He got knocked out. He got put to sleep. Like AJ gave him some NyQuil. And now he's worked his way back up into a prime position to fight for the WBC world title. But instead of sitting idly by, sitting on the sideline, or basically picking a no-hoper, he stepped in the ring against a credible opponent, a top 10 heavyweight, in Alto Valim. And he needs to be saluted for that. Despite the fact that there's other reasons that came into play for him fighting Alto Valim that people don't know about, that I've told you about in this video. So we will see what happens, and we will see what transpires. Let me know your thoughts about Alto Valim versus Dillian White. Who you like in that fight? I think it's a good fight. It's one of the better non-title heavyweight matchups that can be made in boxing today. And I just hope everything is on the up and up with the drug testing. Hopefully they make sure everything is up and up as far as the judging goes. But I kind of a pessimistic on both fronts in that regard. But hopefully, we get everything. Hopefully we get a just outcome in this fight. Whoever deserves to win the fight gets the W. We don't be talking about no shenanigans or somebody got a hometown decision or somebody was in prime position for a world title shot. They didn't want to mess that up. Now, hopefully we won't be talking about that on October 31st. The day after the fight. So we will see what happens, and we will see what transpires. Subscribe to JB Sports, the man, the myth, the legend, and I'll holler.